So this is the chunky boy I used on a trip. And a massive battery in there. Just to try and hold it in the left hand. The black and white viewfinder. So, VCR. Hooked up to this little thing that's hooked up to the computer, that's hooked up to a program that does this, and we get the result.
Suppose I wait for you to go and go up and go to bed.
So what was the plan, trying to make?
Yeah, scraggy little rat. You loser of a mongrel. I hate you.
I tell you what, I just want something that's weird. Did you know? That looks like a triangle and that goes on his own way. Triangle there. On the long one, you got three short one, up to here.
I know how it goes. Yeah, that actually doesn't look like plan A, does it? Might be a bit low to the ground there.
Has he got one long finger here? Two acting across. Yeah, this one is longer, this one is a little shorter even.
Just pull the branch here, see what shape the branch is. No, there's your short one there.
Yeah, that's what I mean. This probably goes to that. It's okay, right?
So we're ready, are we, Mr. Shoko?
Well,
oh well, off we go. That thing for you. Oh well, here we are, about 50k short of Walluna. Mark's run out of fuel. I just filled it up from the jerry can, man. So like, previous shot was halfway. Shot before that was in sandstone. And we got nothing out here but rocks and pea gravel. And one Frenchman and one Australian.
Yeah, these are some black people there. That's
the menu. Well, catch you in Walluna. I should have thought about that, eh? You saw it parked up. Yes, it is Francois.
Some after this it gets really really good. It goes uphill, downhill, good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We'll take some pictures, mate.
Well, here we are, third of the way along the Gun Barrel Highway, and Francis found his house keys that he lost a month ago. They're jammed between his spark plug and his head on his car, on his bike.
Ah! We're going back, does that?
Yeah.
That blew in, Lewis.
Yeah, Greg's bike blew so much bloody oil that he put the... put the breather pipe onto the chain, and it was still blowing so much oil that his bike ended up being covered in it. Oh man, his bike looked like it had blown up by the time he reached Alice Springs. Not really. But you know, once he was in town and he just took it easy. You know, it didn't blow smoke, it's just the high revs all the time. mixed rock we came across, guess who ended up in it? It wasn't Francois. Out of us here we got Mount Beldel, Bendel or Birdel or Bodel. It's about 300 k's out of Carnegie.
You should get into television, Mike.
Here's a stupid little Frenchman who keeps on losing control of his motorbike, running into anthills. Checking if he's got a flat tyre. Well, you almost had a film already, Francois.
No, we're turning there.
A bit down the road, a few k's.
Then bit old trees? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And this is where Greg's Fiat 125 exhaust mounts broke. And we had to use the tie down straps. God, things are looking grim. Sun's setting and we still haven't made it to Warburton. Well, here we are about 80 k's out of Warburton. Pretty much middle of the Australian desert. Not too bad for a desert. Rollinson Range, just short of Giles, about 200 k's outside of Warburton. We have the forest in the middle of nowhere. And Francois are having a piss. You get no beginning of trees, and all of a sudden you get one big straight line.
I love your commentary, Michael. That's class act.
You can hear Francois saying how much he loves me. Don't worry, lady. Pretty sure that one's the Olga's, Francois.
Eh?
Pretty sure that one's the Olga's.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Gee, this is not moving no more though.
Who's not moving?
The only
one. Well, maybe the bike up vertical might make a difference.
Yeah, no, but I did, eh? Like since we're not at the service station, it hasn't moved.
I didn't notice a cloud of smoke when you pulled away.
Yep.
Didn't.
You got a record symbol up in the right-hand corner?
I don't know if he's doing something. I'm pressing your button.
He's pressed it and let it go. If it's got record up in the top right-hand corner.
No, he hasn't.
I'll press it again.
Oh, yeah, no, he has, he has.
Okay.
20-minute record. Is that in colour or is it in black and white?
I'll be in colour. It's one of the older videos.
Do you want to move your head slightly so I can get a big bump in it?
You're cool. Oh, the Aboriginals haven't caught up with us. They must have given up the chase.
Yeah.
know if this is going to come out, but anyway.
Yeah, no worries. Yeah, she's pretty massive. That's Kata Tajuata. Sounds like a bloody Japanese name, doesn't it?
Plug a button in that thing.
Yeah, those ockers, they seem to handle real well, don't they? See the guys sitting inside?
I don't know, nothing.
The problem is the viewfinder is in black and white, so you can't tell if you're looking at the right thing or not.
Like this fist, man. Is that feet walking?
Nah, trust me, Francois. Read the instructions.
I don't have any with me.
Yeah, not not bad, eh?
Have you seen what side by where what says Eden Valley?
One for Mike on the full off stakes. Front bolt came out of the caliper, locked up. While I was doing almost 200 kilometres an hour coming down a rocky hill. But managed to save the bike and myself and still able to continue the journey after minor repairs. Remember Greg said he hit ant's nest with his front wheel and went over the handlebars? Yeah. I wonder if it was this big.
That would hurt. Probably just a two-inch attraction thing.
Yeah, yeah. Home of the big ant's nest.
Yeah, it's probably made out of fucking mesh or something. But when you went, you just put up.
Hey. My camera reckons it's not enough light to film. It's going to be interesting to see how this turns out. Here we are in Queensland, 2 hours ahead of us. It's inside the Dangy pub.